Hello students and the warmer welcome in this new session of the new chapter. So students, in this new video we will be starting the new chapter, which is oscillation. So you no need to be take any stress student, because if you're learning in the very simplest way, then it will be very easy for all of you. So students, as you can see, I have draw one rough diagram. The horizontal line is one of the hinged part or the hinged support to which the rubber is tied, and at the end of that rubber there is one stone is tied. So students, if we apply one condition to this diagram, suppose that stone which is tied to that rubber, we will leave it from the hinged support, then what will happen? That stone will come down at its extreme position of that rubber, means that maximum stretched will be there of that rubber with the help of the weight of that stone which has been tied to that rubber. Now students, this stone will follow the number of positions. First of all, that rubber will be get stretched in downward direction due to the weight of that stone. After that stretching, the stone will try to come back to its original position from which the stone has been left. So there is the motion of that stone which is tied to that rubber at its very extreme condition again toward its initial position. So that is nothing but the one of the example of the oscillation. Now students, for your better understanding, we will be seeing the perfect example with the perfect diagram. So students, example of the oscillation, the diagram of example of oscillation is popping on your screen. And you can see the one of the spring which is attached to the hinged support which is horizontal, and at the other end of that spring the block is hinged. So in simple, this is the arrangement of spring. At its one end there is a block attached, while at its other end, which is hinged, which is supported by the hinged support which is rigidly fixed. So this is nothing but the arrangement to take an example of the oscillation. Now students, we are going to apply one condition over this diagram. What will happen if I stretch this block toward the right? Then students, that right block will stretch that spring again towards at the right side, means that spring will be get stretched due to that block, due to the weight of that block, and that spring will get stretched from the rigid support. Thus the length of that spring will be increased, and the unwinding of the of that spring will be occur there. So as you can see, the block will be get stretched toward the right, then the movement of that spring will be also towards the right. Hence students, we can say that the block will tends to unwinding the spring and move towards the right. So this will be the first case when we pull that block towards the right with the help of its weight or with the help of some stretch condition. Now we will see the second condition. So in this second condition, we can see that firstly we have just pulled that block toward the right, and we have to remove that block. Now we have to remove that block from it at its extreme position up to which we have just stretched that block. Now we have to, if we remove that block, then it will try to come towards its original condition, means more than its original condition, it will come further left than that its original condition, means it will come toward the left with the very high force and high motion. Hence again, the movement of block will be towards the left, and there will be winding of spring will be there as the block is coming toward the rigid support. So there will be the winding of that spring, and thus that the object, means the block, will come further than that its original condition, means that block will come maximum toward the rigid support. Now once that block will come maximum at its extreme position towards the rigid support, then again that block will move towards the right. Now the point, the at first the point which has attained by that block, now just before that the block will reach. Means, suppose in first stretch the block has attained the position at point A, then the block has moved toward the rigid support. Then again the block will move toward the right. Now this time it will attain the length, means it will attain the position just before the A. Means, say you can consider the block will attain the position at the point at somewhere B, means closer to the B. Now again the block will move toward the rigid support, and again the block will move again to the right, toward the right. Then again the block will not reach the B, it will just reach just before the B. So this will be the remains continuous, means to and fro motion of the block, means right and left motion of the block will occur. This is nothing but the to and fro motion of the block, and this is nothing but, students, the oscillation of the particle. Now students, we will see the exact definition which we are going to learn from the book. Now students, here we can say that oscillatory motion is the motion of the particle in to and fro manner, which repeats after definite interval of time. We can say that it is the oscillatory motion. Now as far as the examples of this oscillatory motions are concerned, you can say pendulum is one of the example of oscillatory motion, and other one example which is most familiar to you is the guitar string. When you handling the guitar, then you have to move that string, and in a way that string will move in to and fro motion. So that is nothing but one of the example of the oscillatory motion, which repeats after definite interval of time. Means that motion has to be repetitions, that motion has to perform repetitions in order to fulfill the definition of the oscillations. Then it will be the example of oscillatory motion or the oscillations. Now students, as far as the difference between oscillatory motion and the periodic motion is concerned, the oscillatory motion may be also called as a periodic motion, but the periodic motion will not be called as an oscillatory motion. The reason behind this statement I will explain ahead. Now students, as far as the definition of periodic motion is concerned, the motion which repeats after certain interval of time is called as a periodic motion. Now we will understand this definition. It is the one kind of motion which repeats after certain interval of time. Suppose you can say after 1 second, 2 second or 1 minute, but it has to be repeat, means at definite time interval it has to be repeat many times, then we can say it is the periodic motion. But student, one question we have to discuss about it is that we can say that the oscillatory motion may be also called as the periodic motion, but periodic motion cannot be called as the oscillatory motion. What is the reason behind that, behind this statement? What you can guess, students? Do you have any idea or any guesses that why this statement has to be stated? So the statement, so the reason behind this is, the as far as the definition of oscillatory motion is concerned, it is the to and fro motion of the particle, and it has to be repeat after definite interval of time, then we can say it is the oscillations or oscillatory motion. But in case of the periodic motion, the definition is the motion which repeats after certain interval of time. No doubt this case is common between the two cases, means in the oscillation also and in the periodic motion. But in the periodic motion there is no to and fro motion, it's obligatory, or you can say it is not necessary to define the periodic motion. Thus students, we can say that the oscillatory motion can be concluded as the periodic motion, but the periodic motion cannot be concluded as a oscillatory motion. This is the main reason behind that, student. So you have to differentiate this both thing for your understanding, then you will be able to see that difference between these two concepts. Means the pendulum may be the example of both of these. Means pendulum also possesses the periodic motion, it repeats, it's a point at which it has started and the point at which it has ended, and it possesses the example, it can be also called as an example of the oscillations. So we will see in detail ahead. Now students, we will understand the further concepts which are related to the oscillations and which are necessary to study about the oscillations. Now the term is the periodic time, or you can also say this term as a time period. Now the definition of the time period or the periodic time is the time taken by the particle to complete one oscillation is called as time period or the periodic time. Means suppose the particle is taking a 2 second, or you can say the 5 second, to complete its one oscillation. One oscillation means student, it starts at the point and goes to the final point, and again it comes to its initial point. So that will be its one oscillation, and the time taken by the particle to complete such a one oscillation, then we can say that it is the periodic time of that particle or the time period of that particular particle. And the time period is denoted by the capital letter T. Now students, there is one more definition or one more concept that we are going to learn and which is necessary to study the oscillation, and it is nothing but the frequency. So students, as far as the frequency is concerned, the frequency is defined as the number of oscillations completed by the particle per unit time is called as the frequency, or the number of oscillations completed by the particle in unit time is called as a frequency. Suppose I have one particle, and that particle is performing oscillations. So suppose that particle perform the oscillations, or 60 oscillations perform that particle in 1 minute or any time interval, then you can say the frequency of that particle is 60. Okay, so this is the definition of the frequency. Now, and as far as the notation of the frequency is concerned, the frequency is indicated by the small letter n. So that is the indication of the frequency. So students, these two important terms we have learned. First one is periodic motion. So I will revise one more time that you will understand easily. Periodic motion is defined as the time taken by the particle to complete one oscillation is called as a periodic motion. So in unit time, how much oscillation does the particle concern? So that time will be the periodic time or the time period of that particular particle of the oscillation. Now, and the second term we have learned is the frequency. And the frequency is nothing but the number of oscillations completed by the particle in unit time or per unit time is called as a frequency, and the frequency is denoted by the small letter n. So these are the frequency and the time period. And so students, in this oscillation chapter, we have to learn frequently, we have to repeat frequently this time period or the periodic time and the frequency. We have to see the examples based on that, and we have to calculate the periodic motion or time period and the frequency. If they have told us to calculate in the example, in few of the example they may give the time period and they will ask for the frequency, and in some examples they will giving the frequency and we have to calculate the time period. So these are the vice versa case we have to calculate in the exam or in the exercise. So these are the important terms that we have to learn about, and it's a definition we have seen. Now it's a formula and the way of calculation we will see ahead in this chapter. Now students, the next part we are going to see is linear SHM, but in detail we will see in the next video, because it is lengthy part and it is necessary to understand in a very simple way. So we will learn this in the next video, but before that we will take a simple overview over this point. So the linear SHM means, as we have already learned, that the particle performing oscillations and it will cause the certain amount of acceleration, velocity and the displacement, and this can be represented by the sines and cosines. And the system which obeys this function is called as a linear SHM, or the SHM means, students, a simple harmonic motions in which we are going to use the sines and cosines, and based on this we will calculating the velocity, acceleration and the displacement of that particle. So these are the few concepts that we have learned in this first video of the oscillation. Now the next part of this chapter we will learn in the next video, students, but till then you have to just revise the point which I have taught you, and so we will see you in the next video. Thank you so much.